Hello everybody, and in this video we'll be having yet another look at Opera Mini. This time it is on a Huawei T510, and again, as you probably know, we have had a look at Opera Mini quite a few times on the Samsung Galaxy Tab A and the Fire tablet for Dolby Atmos compatibility, which I will touch on in a minute. But in the meantime, we're going to have a look at the Opera Mini on the Huawei T510. A few things first though. So first of all, subscribe to my channel and like my page in the description. And this tablet does have a vibrator on that, so if you do hear some strange humming or some vibrating, then you know, that is the tablet. So again, hopefully that won't be too annoying to you all, but again, just excuse that. So let's go on to why we're testing Opera Mini again on another device. Now, Huawei... So Huawei, first of all, aside from all its political thing that it has in the news, are actually quite good in terms of their technology, and they do their sound technology, which is called Huawei Hisense. So again, it's sort of like Huawei's version of Dolby Atmos, but again, I think some phones come with Dolby and the Huawei Hisense technology. This just comes with Huawei Hisense, and again, I don't know why they didn't include the Dolby Atmos, because again, a lot of tablets do come with Dolby and Huawei. But again, the sound is surprisingly sharp on this tablet. But again, I thought we'll test Opera Mini since it is Dolby Atmos compatible on Fire tablet, and I have been using Firefox to watch my videos, so we want to see whether, because Opera Mini is Dolby Atmos on Fire tablet, whether it will have a similar outcome on the Huawei Hisense on Huawei tablets. And if it does, we will be testing Dolby Atmos browsers on Huawei tablet. But in the meantime, let us test Opera Mini. Right, so we have Opera Mini and we have Opera Mini Beta. In fact, let us take a look at the Opera Mini Beta. Sorry, because that was the one that was Dolby Atmos compatible, not Opera Mini Beta. So again, sorry for the confusion. Alright, so it's got Light and Fast Browser. And it's got Continue.
You can always manage while we provide ad-free web browsing. Our partners can display ads within the browser's home screen.
Okay then, so while we provide ad-free browsing, our partners can still provide adverts. So, again, this is a browser that does use advertising, and again, a few browsers do use advertising, and the browsers that do use advertising are fairly unknown, but Opera is the only known browser that does use advertising. So again, what is that? Right, so you've got your sites here.
eBay, Facebook, Google, Instagram, and eBay, booking.com.
So you've got Facebook, Instagram, eBay.com. Mano,
Disney, Vodafone, 3,
and Vodafone.
JD Williams,
and you've got JD Williams.
Search,
so again, Williams, we didn't really see 12, that many sites on the Fire tablet, and it's probably because this is a 10.1 and I'm using it landscape ways, I'm wondering whether it is using the WOM on the top row to pack more sites in. So, you know, hence we are seeing all these interesting sites. But again, it has been a while since we have had a look at Oppo Mini Beta, and we do know that things can change in a while, i.e. Oppo introduce a system update to their Oppo Mini Beta browsers. Now you've got CNN. And all that not. And I must admit, you do have a main menu at the bottom. And again, I think we mainly saw the menu at the bottom of the screen. No, at the top of the screen, rather. So it was a little bit of a shock just to see the menu at the bottom. So you will have to bear with me because I'm using another tablet and it takes a while getting used to. So if I'm a bit slow, just bear with me. I think what we might do is we might actually cut this video and then once we find a sensible place we can pick up from, we'll be back with it. So I'll see you in a bit. Alright then, we found the main menu and it is at the bottom of the screen. And one of the things I should say is tablets these days are coming without a home button. And this T510 is one of them. And because the main menu is at the bottom of the screen along with the home, back and recent apps buttons, or the overview buttons depending on what tablet you have, you can inadvertently catch one of them when wanting to click on a browser function. So that is why the Oppo Mini Beta really should have the menu icons at the top. But this is not the only browser that has such a layout, so again, that goes for all browsers. So that's one of the things you've got to look out for when getting a touchscreen tablet, especially if you're moving from an older to a newer tablet, because a lot of older tablets did have home buttons and newer tablets are coming without home buttons, which I think is a little bit sad just to get more imagery in. But again, they could mount a button on the side or whatever, but again, that is the way things are. Also, we've got the search engine next to the address bar to the left, and again, that was there before, so what is that? Now, going back to the main menu icon, and it should really be to the far right of the screen, because that is where screen reader users will look to find menu icons and that in their common places. So again, common places include the more options in the top right hand corner of any app, not just browser apps, and the navigation drawer in the top left. And again, those are screen reader users' common places. So again, it would be nice if the menu was to the bottom right hand side of the screen, no matter what screen size you have. Sorry, just bear with us. Now, we can still see the address bar, which can be very confusing to screen reader users, and that is an Oppo thing. Another Oppo thing is the grid format, and some of them have been partial grids, so a little bit of list and a little bit of grid in the menu as opposed to entire grid. So that's something that can cause accessibility problems to screen reader user. So you've got settings. Tap history, exit, set night mode, setting history. And I must admit, I do think that the icons are quite crammed together in the grid horizontally, so it would be nice if it was just an entire list. Now, one thing that you do have that Chrome doesn't is a night mode function, and again that filters out the blue light that is emitted from LCD displays, because again the blue light can hinder the production of the sleep hormone melatonin, and again to guarantee that you get a good night's sleep they do suggest to turn night mode on. So it is useful if your device doesn't have a night mode, but I will suggest turning night mode on both of your devices, so your device and the app, just to, you know, make sure that no blue light does leak out, because again I think we've had problems with apps' own video players showing blue light because they override the devices tolerances. Anyway, one of the great things that this Opera browser has is that you can actually save offline pages. So if you don't, so if you like Opera, you can save articles to read offline without saving, without installing a third party app like Pocket. So in the settings you've got another night mode option again. You've got general, personalization. I must admit, it will be nice for a device like this, given its size, it will have a split screen view, because again, it just makes things in a flow order. Again, that is the way we have it. You got ad blocking enabled, full screen browsing. And again, it would be nice if the full screen was like a toggle on and off switch. Might even have a few options in the settings, because again, it would be nice if you could save those extra processes to click on full screen browsing. Just trying to look for an accessibility section. Not too sure whether it is in the advanced section. So let's have a look in the advanced section. But again, the accessibility section should be more easier to find. Nope. Well, there is no accessibility section anywhere. Okay then, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my YouTube app and I'm going to get a video, and we're going to perform our Huawei Hisn test. So again, Huawei Hisn is Huawei's version of Dolby Atmos, and if this browser does produce the same Dolby Atmos outcome like it did on the Fire tablet, it therefore means that we've got more browser tests to perform on the Huawei T510 as well as the Fire tablet, because we will be continuing our Dolby Atmos Fire tablet series. So what we're going to do is we're going to cut the video and then
Opera Mini Beta.
Right then folks, we are back with you now, and I'm going to turn the screen reader off and we're going to turn the volume up a little bit so you can give this video a listen. Oh, And one thing I must admit, the sound on this is fairly good, even though it hasn't got Dolby Atmos on board. So, what we might do is we might open Firefox and play the same video through that, so we can actually see, and you can see for yourself, whether you think the Opera Mini delivers the same Dolby Atmos standards, shall we say, that it delivered on the Fire tablet. Now, for those of you who are not too sure what the Dolby Atmos and Fire tablet scenario is, basically, the Amazon has always shipped their devices with some sort of Dolby software, and what you probably find is when you watch videos on your Fire tablet through some browsers, the sound coming from your speakers is not as rich as it should be, so I must admit, this copying and pasting on a tablet without a Bluetooth keyboard is quite a headache, I must admit. Here we go. We've got the link copied now.
Video.
Right.
Tap to Daniela, the vamps. Too good to be true. Audio feed machine.
Right then. I think they're about the same, personally. Is this real life? Something about you. You were too good to be true. Though I think I've heard a little bit more bass with the Chrome compared to the Opera Mini Beta, which is quite surprising, really. So, again, I hope you've found the sound test helpful for yourselves. In conclusion, the Opera Mini Beta is no different on the Huawei tablet compared to the Fire tablet or the Chromebook for a number of reasons. First of all, you still get the same Opera problems, so like the grid and the partial grid layout. The address bar is always there, whether you have the menu up or not, which can confuse screen reader users. And the in the menu, the icons in the horizontal section of the grid are quite crammed together, so that can cause confusion for screen reader users and probably be problematic to everyone as well. So the Opera Mini Beta doesn't really produce the same Dolby Atmos standards that on the Huawei tablet as it produced on the Fire tablet. So overall, I don't think we'll need to do any Dolby Atmos or Huawei Hisense tests on the Huawei tablet when testing browsers. So again, that is one less load off the group, but don't worry, you will see some more Huawei content. So, I hope you've enjoyed this video and found it helpful. Thanks again. Stay tuned for more videos to come, and we will see you soon.